folks, welcome to my YouTube channel. Thanks for clicking on this video. Please like and subscribe. My name is Brian, and I am into outdoors, crabbing, fishing, hunting, off-roading, and spending time with my kids and my family. One of the things we like to do is fish and crab and crawdad, going after crayfish. These are my new floats, and I wanted to share it with all of you guys. So please stay tuned and learn how I made these on a budget. These run about $7 each, and they're rather fun, and I think the kids should love them. My floats I have been making with Dollar Tree pool noodles. I've been making them for 5 years. This was my first ones. If you guys crab in Oregon or Washington, you've probably seen my buoys out there. This is a Dollar Tree pool noodle connector. I just didn't like hunting for my pool noodles, or sorry, my crab pots, and I thought I'd use some pool noodles. Now, I did see a crayfish video from about 14 years ago where the gentleman used just a short section of 3/4 PVC with a cut pool noodle on it, and it was probably about 12 inches, and I hadn't seen anybody really use them. I think fishing and stuff did something similar, but hopefully this hack for an awesome, reliable identifier float will be quality enough to maybe make it to fishing and stuff. So we're going to start with a 3/4 inch, 200 PSI, that's the thinner duty stuff, and we're going to take a Dollar Tree pool noodle, and we're going to cut it into 8-inch pieces. I'm using red, white, and blue. You can use any color. You don't have to cut it down. You can simply cut 24 inches of pool noodle and stick it on 3-foot piece of 3/4 inch or 1/2 inch. I am using 3/4 inch because our line weight with snap that you get from Cabela's, they're about $8 a piece of Cabela's, or you can go online to eBay and Amazon, you get 2 for $8, which for me, better deal. So we're gonna just, so simple. We're gonna take glue and stick it on here, and take white. You want to keep it going straight because it will try to go crooked. And when you're picking up your pool noodles, you will want to watch the diameter of the hole. You will see some are larger than others. If you're doing 1/2 inch, obviously you want the smaller holes. If you're doing 3/4, you want the bigger ones. And then we will put the red on here. Now again, you can do just one color or two colors, or you could cut them into smaller chunks and do 8 colors if you wanted. These are just what I make. Now, one little trick I use hairspray as my glue. You could use hot glue, you could not glue them at all and put a cap on the top. I use hairspray because that's what I use on my motorcycle grips, and it seems to work good for me. That real quick, light it up a little more. Now this might not last forever and it might not hold perfect, but this is a little cheap thing. And what I'm going to do here is, I know I cut my pool noodles to 8 inches, so I'm just going to put a little line there with my marker, and that's going to be my top. So it'll take about 15 minutes for that to dry. And they fit pretty snug, so like I said, that's just a little extra. And then, so there you go. That's that part done. We're going to open up one of these weighted snaps. Now these are crabbing things. Whether you have floating line or lead line, these are always a good idea, because what these do is make even your styrofoam buoys, when you weight it down, weight your line down, it'll make them stand up and stay in one place. So it kind of holds them against the current a little better. So this just happens to fit perfect. It's just too awesome. So now you're probably going to want to put some hot glue or epoxy. I'm just using a drill and a screw. You're going to want to use stainless hardware on this because we're using them in salt water. And salt water likes to corrode things. Just use a Home Depot stainless screw here. Drilled a little pilot hole. May not need to do that, but I did. There you go. Nice solid connection. I don't think that's going to fail. Holding up a pot. And then, for a little more fun, I found some vinyl at Dollar Tree. And I opted for the iron-on stuff. Well, I don't want iron. So, these are Dollar Tree clamps. They work for as long as they work, and then you can only get more. It's Dollar Tree. So I just put a little clamp on that. These come in a 1-foot by 1-foot square, and I just cut it into 4 even pieces. And then I will take my hot glue gun, or hot glue gun, heat gun, and I will heat this up, leaving a little thing on here, and then I will take this and move the clamp down around the PVC. Like so. You'll put your clamp on and finish heating that up with the heat gun. And you will end up with something that looks like this. And from here, you're going to use this as your primary buoy. I like to run 2 with a line between them so that you can use a gaff to grab them. Obviously, these will stick straight up and down out of the water, so you could just grab these and not use a gaff. These are just a really handy crabbing, crawfishing, whether you're going after blue crab on the East Coast or dungeness on the West, or crayfish worldwide. They're a great little float, and like I said, $7-8. How cool is that? Thank you for watching. Please like and